Jongetjes! Eindelijk!
I'm Richard Crenna. Welcome to Philadelphia. Oh, and the reason I'm doing this is to show you how easy you can lose your breath running up Philadelphia's most famous steps. The steps of the Art Museum, made famous by Rocky. Woo! Enough of that. Well, this is where it all started 14 years ago. Thanks to a young man who lived just a few miles from here, we were introduced to a character that would go on to become one of the most beloved and popular heroes in film history. The young man who created this champion of the people was Michael Sylvester Stallone. And the character he created was known simply as Rock.
Take you back, take you back.
From the streets
cometh a man,
a fighter,
doing the best that I can.
Tonight, we meet a real American hero, one of Hollywood's most famous rags-to-riches stories. It was a million-to-one shot, Sylvester Stallone and Rocky.
It's a miracle. By today's standards, if someone came into me and said to do the same thing, I'd say, are you crazy? Are you crazy? That is impossible. It can't happen. It won't work. Get out of my office, you know?
Take this. Next, a father and son story. When it came to choosing a special young actor to play Rocky Jr., the filmmakers selected the one young man who was born to play the part. Stallone's real son, 14-year-old Sage, who's making his acting debut.
You got the part. I did.
We'll also travel cross-country from Philadelphia to Los Angeles for an exclusive inside look at the making of Rocky V.
I've never seen a response like this.
And in a television first, we'll witness an historic meeting.
You know, I don't believe it, but I'm going to meet Sylvester Stallone in person. I'm going to punch him right in the mouth, too.
Stallone and Rocky, together for the first time.
Millions instantly identified with this man. We love rooting for the underdog. We're fascinated with rags-to-riches fantasies. It was the American dream. And when we cheered for Rocky, we cheered for ourselves. So tonight, we tell the story of two men, Sylvester Stallone and his good friend Rocky Balboa. Get a feel for the people of Philly. This is the place to come, the Italian Market. It was on this exact street that Rocky was running when suddenly someone threw an orange at him. I guess it goes with the territory. The year was 1976. The tall ships were sailing into New York Harbor to kick off the bicentennial. Jimmy Carter had been elected president. Gasoline was 59 cents a gallon. And a new film named Rocky was number one in America.
Take it back. 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 Take it back.
From the streets
cometh a man,
a fighter,
doing the best that I can
to survive.
Yes, and the survival of the fittest. Strive for what is mine. The Lord is my witness. Many believe in what they see,
and I wonder,
what do they see in me? For a man, he must walk alone
to grow
and to bring his knowledge home. School of hard knocks is my alma mater. Made it up, you know that I got her. Fame and fortune never a concern.
I got mine,
so the home I return.
In 1976, Sylvester Stallone created a different kind of hero.
Hey, Rock, heard you did real good last night.
Absolutely, should have seen me.
An underdog long-shot hero named Rocky Balboa.
Italian stallion.
Rocky was a down-and-out fighter. His entire life was a million-to-one shot.
I put it into the boxing format, which is a great metaphor, a great symbol, fighting against, you know, a champion against a challenger, which is really what life is all about.
A gamble. You see, I gotta take the chance, or in the mirror at myself I cannot glance.
You believe that America is the land of opportunity?
Yeah.
Apollo Creed does. And he's gonna prove it to the whole world by giving an unknown a shot at the title.
The man needs a challenge to bring out his essence and his finest qualities.
This was Rocky's opportunity to prove that in spite of what the world might perceive, he wasn't a failure.
You know what you are?
What?
You're a tomato.
Tomato?
Yeah.
And if this broken down boxer could do it, then anything was possible.
When we're cheering for Rocky, we're basically rooting ourselves on.
It's hard to believe how one modest little movie could provide so many great moments.
Why do you want to fight?
Because I can't sing a dance. Hey, yo.
The language.
Yo, Adrian, it's me, Rocky.
That thing has been following me. Yo.
Yo, you look great.
I didn't invent yo.
Yo, Adrian.
Yo is a term that seems to be indigenous to Philadelphia. Everyone's yo this, yo, 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 yo,
yo. Yo!
Now it's like yo MTV Raps, yo this, yo, yo.
Yo, Adrian.
Yo.
The characters.
Is that a face you can trust or what? Huh?
Rocky has always been applied to a ne'er-do-well. Tough guy, lacking in any social graces, but solid.
Adrian.
Always knew he was free.
Don't tease me.
It's easy.
And they discover love, and they discover potential, and they're willing to take great risks.
Paulie.
Come on, don't breed on me, Paulie, huh?
He's everybody's garbage can, I guess. Everything that we want to, we think that we wouldn't say, Paulie says.
Keep out of my freaking life!
And Mick.
I want to be your manager.
Fight said I don't need no manager.
But you can't buy what I'm going to give you. I mean, I've got pain and I've got experience.
Well, I got pain, I've got experience too.
Looking back, it appears that Rocky was always destined for greatness. But that's not the case. Rocky and writer-actor Sylvester Stallone were each in their own way a long shot, reaching for that one last chance life was throwing their way.
And when I presented it to the studio, they said, fine, but you can't be in it. And I realized this was my shot, this was my moment. I knew that if I sold the script and it went on to someone else and it was successful, I would have such a constant nagging of self-loathing for the rest of my life that I wasn't about to do it. So I took the shot. I gambled. It's like going to Las Vegas and putting all your money on one big ride.
Stallone's gamble paid off, and he became Rocky.
It was a miracle. By today's standards, if someone came into me and said to do the same thing, I'd say, are you crazy? Are you crazy? That is impossible. It can't happen. It won't work. Get out of my office, you know? But luckily, they didn't say that.
Bill Conti's music made a great contribution to the movie.
John Avildsen handheld the camera with a handheld camera. He had R-O-C-K-Y and went like this with it. He says, you should have some kind of fanfare that says, let's begin this movie. So I went down, bam, da 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 da. So we had a fanfare.
It's a very inspirational song. It's a song that makes you want to achieve.
For Rocky, success wasn't in winning the fight with Apollo Creed. One moment in particular will forever define the character of Rocky Balboa.
It was the night before the fight, the first fight with Apollo Creed.
I can't beat him.
And he says to Adrian that he doesn't care whether he wins the fight or loses the fight.
He just wants to be standing. I would just want to be standing.
It really don't matter if I lose this fight. All I want to do is go to distance. I want to know for the first time in my life, see? That I weren't just another bum from the neighborhood.
And that was a one-take shot. We ran out of money. I said, please, I'm begging you, shoot this scene. Without this scene, the movie means nothing. It's just a fighter. So that to me is a key scene.
All I heard with the chants and cheers, you're a champ. Now what you gonna do when it's true? You don't believe in you.
The first one, nobody had any expectations. It was a very low budget picture. I figured it would be on the bottom half of a double bill playing in a drive-in in Tennessee somewhere. So when it hit, It was a most pleasant surprise.
The first filming we had, we had scheduled some friends and some professional people in the industry that we knew. When the picture was over, there was first a stunned silence and then a major round of applause. And these people, who were all very sophisticated about this industry, got up from their seats. And that night, Stallone was a star.
Rocky went on to make $117 million, and Sylvester Stallone became an overnight sensation.
This character, this broken-down, simple boxer, has brought all this to me. This fella created me. It was like vice versa. We did it to each other.
Sylvester was the youngster that said, I'd like to revisit the character every 3-4 years and see what's happening to him in the vice versa of the world. And I thought he was a crackpot.
It really does take it through every chapter of my life and every chapter of certain celebrities' life, where you start out as an unknown.
I think everybody I fight is a bum.
Well, ain't they?
Then you get a little taste of success and you want that one more shot and you do succeed.
I can't believe this has happened.
And the third one where you become corrupted, you become overwhelmed with your own image.
That hurts! You gotta fight him, you gotta move! What's the matter with you?
And the fourth one is when you become so big that you now no longer belong to the neighborhood or the country, you become international.
I must break you.
The last one is extremely honest.
I know I made a few mistakes, you know, but I would love to handle what you can. It's just gonna be you and me this time.
Home to you?
Yeah. Home to you.
I try to do my best. I give that speech to myself every time I do a scene, and I say, this is it. It's on film forever. You may be lazy, you may be tired, you may even be sick, but remember one thing. You can't go back. You can't buy it for all the money in the world. This is your moment. So dig deep. If you've got it, give it. Just know that you gave it 1,000%, and that's it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
I love you.
I love you. I love you.
Through the first four films, Rocky and Adrian and Paulie and Mickey weren't just characters on the screen. They had lives with which we could all identify. They were real people. They believed in loyalty, strong family values. And speaking of family, in Rocky V, Sylvester's 14-year-old son, Sage, makes his acting debut. A father and son story coming up next.
Did I tell the story in a way? Because if somebody wrote a story about the way this picture came about, people would not believe it, right?
That's true. It was quite a long shot. If I had known it was going to be this difficult, I wouldn't have done it, you know.
Really?
Yeah, because I think it was a classic case of blissful stupidity. No, really, seriously, because I didn't know you couldn't do something like this, therefore I didn't try. So to me, it seemed very normal honking your horn in the driveway with the producer and tapping on his window at all hours of the night and saying, please, 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 and eventually, I think they just gave me the money to go away. No, seriously, go away.
What do I think of Sylvester Stallone? I think he's one of the finest actors America has to offer. I really believe that he should have won an Academy Award for each one of his pictures. Is that each one of his pictures? I'm sorry, you're going to have to hold the card up. No, just hold it up so I can see it. That's right. That's what you wanted me to say, isn't it, Sly? An Academy Award for each one of them. Yeah, okay. Let's just do it again.
When the producers were looking for a young man to play Rocky Jr. in Rocky V, they auditioned hundreds of hopefuls, trying to find a young man that looked like Rocky, that knew a little bit about boxing, and had the potential to develop a special on-screen relationship with Sylvester Stallone. Well, as it turned out, the producers took a chance and hired an unknown, an inexperienced young man who probably knows Sly better than anyone, his 14-year-old son, Sage.
He was born in the Hell's Kitchen section of New York City in 1946. Moved to Philly with his mom when his parents split up. His mouth tilts down to the right because of an accident at birth. At age 8, kids called him Slant Mouth. That's when he started fighting. You know him as Sylvester. He's my dad. This is Dad's first date. He's had a lot since then. In high school, they told him he should be an elevator repairman, but he had other plans. As Rocky's kid, Dad wanted me to know how to defend myself. I hated it at first. Now, I love it. It also prepared me for my first acting job, Rocky Jr. I'm 14. My name is Sage Stallone.
This is for getting Father's Day. This is for getting Mother's Day. And this is for pulling Santa's whiskers. Here it comes. Not that I never wanted to do that for real, but...
I was born during Rocky I, and I remember when I watched the movie and when I saw him acting, I thought it was real. I thought it was real, like when I saw him getting beat up in the ring, I'm like, no, Daddy, right? And he's getting beat up in the ring, I'm going, no!
Growing up in the atmosphere that he's been raised in has been very difficult. Especially for someone to get a real solid base of self. Who am I? Do I have my own identity? And I thought if this child was ever to develop a real sense of self-worth, I would like for him to enter my arena and perform well and stand on his own 2 feet, not one or two lines, but really carry the brunt of the responsibility on his shoulders. So he did.
Hey, yo!
What are you doing?
What you doing here? Oh, wow, you did this.
I suppose every kid has a fantasy of wanting to take, to participate in some film in some capacity. So when Rocky came around...
My dad came to my room with a script.
He didn't push the issue, actually it was me.
I said, thanks, Dad.
To some extent, I looked upon it as an indulgence to Sylvester.
I went to audition for the role.
So I wouldn't be accused of nepotism.
So I go up to the director's house, John Avildsen.
When I first heard that he was going to come over and read, I thought, you know, nepotism is okay if you keep it in the family.
I'm saying my lines, I'm doing great.
It was not a fiat accompli.
A little more emotion. I'm going, oh, okay.
But I was quite impressed.
I thought I was gonna, totally fail.
He delivered.
And he was brilliant, practically from the first day.
You got the part. I did.
You step. You throw your left, right? You get it, Tom. Well, advice. He asked for a good agent. That was, I kind of feel like he was getting a little ahead of the game there.
Let's talk.
Well, I feel like you're my boy, and we're supposed to be close.
No, what you want is you and Tommy be tight. That's what you're really talking about.
You're wrong.
Hey, that's who you really want to spend your time with.
Don't say that.
Since he's been here, it's Tommy this, Tommy that. You don't have no time for nobody, so I got no time for you. Go. I remember when we did the scene when we were down in the room. It was like I totally forgot that he was my father, my real father, that he was Sylvester Stallone as a father. It was like I was Rocky Jr., he was Rocky. I was totally into the part.
Sylvester really has to stay on his toes to keep up with Sage when they're both in the same frame. Sage is very good.
Dad, I gotta go.
Oh, yeah, I don't want you to be late for school. You know, on your first day here, use the side entrance, okay? Hey, wait, what's this? Goodness gracious, where'd this come from? It's a strange place to stash your lunch money, you know?
I have to say that there are moments when I was holding my breath because he could go over the top or under the top, whatever, if he didn't hit that mark just right, that moment. And he was very, very true. So I'm quite proud of him. I can retire next week. Thank God.
Yo, Adrian! I don't know.
Sage's connection with the Rocky films has an ironic beginning. When Rocky I was being filmed, Sly's former wife, Sasha, was pregnant. She watched the film being made. Soon after, she gave birth to a son. His name was Sage.
It's been a great thrill to see this happen to Sage and for Sylvester as well. I think it's been a wonderful experience for the two of them. It's been very important, far beyond its implications for the film, and I'm happy about that.
But Daddy loves you. You're number one. Home team.
When I see you having all these things that I didn't have, I live through your eyes. We just gotta stick together, eh? Thank you for being born. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, Dad. I love you.
We'll be right back with more of Rocky, an American hero.
Why do you think the Rocky character has been so appealing to people?
Because he's a gentle soul. He seems like a you know, an honest, gentle person who's just trying to do the right thing.
What impressed me the most about the Rocky films is the constant theme to be the very best that you can be. The emphasis of the film wasn't so much on winning as opposed to the honesty, determination, the hard work, you know, reaching for your dreams and things like that.
Eric, ready? Okay, let's see.
Hold on.
You can see the microphone. People know you use them. Here, bring it down here. Bring it down here real close. Turn it upside down. Yeah, there you go. Right there. Okay, ready? Okay, ready? Okay, let's see if I can do a real good Yo Adrian.
Yo Adrian. Yo Adrian.
That's not bad.
Yo Sly.
I'm here with Pete DeRita, whose family has been in this neighborhood for how many years now, Pete?
Close to 50 years.
50 years?
Yes, sir.
The same place?
We used to have a store down the street. The last few years, we've been here with our poultry family.
So you saw all the Rockies made on this street?
Everyone.
Good. How do you feel about that?
Very proud. If they have any other showings, any other movies about Rocky, I wish they show them right here at the Italian Market.
Great. Well, thanks, Pete.
Thank
you. I don't want to take too much time.
Good day.
We'll be back to the show in a minute. But first, I think I'll pick up some tomatoes for my wife. She loves tomatoes, mozzarella, a little basil, you know. Excuse me. Are these tomatoes ripe?
Are these tomatoes ripe? They're Jersey tomatoes. Jersey, South Paws, South Jersey, you know what I'm saying?
How do you know that is a Jersey tomato?
Hey, listen, how do you know it says it there? It's a Jersey, you know what I'm saying? What's up, you wise guy or something?
Okay,
eh?
We got that settled.
Yeah.
Now, can you tell me where I can get a great Philly cheesesteak?
Hey, you want a Philly cheesesteak? About six blocks up, you got to get a Philly cheesesteak. I'm the best in the world.
Six
you know
blocks?
Yeah.
No, I can't go six blocks. No, we're here. We're doing a show. I have to stay here. I can't leave.
What are you, crazy? I mean, Rock would have been up and back in a second there because the guy is a wrecking machine. He's got talent. He's a killer. I don't have time for this. I got to get back to the gym. It's driving me nuts.
Those voices sounded so familiar.
Next up, we go on location in Philadelphia and behind the scenes in Los Angeles for the production of Rocky V. And we'll meet two people who've shared the ride to the top, Sylvester Stallone and Rocky Balboa.
Well, actually, the first time
I was supposedly going to run up these steps in Rocky One. My intent was to carry up Butkus. The dog was like 152,000 pounds at the time. And I went halfway up the steps and said, oh, scrap this idea, okay? Does anyone have a chihuahua? No, okay, forget it. Dog out, Stallone up alone. And, but God knows, I never had any idea that the steps would continue to be a reoccurring theme. And really, it's just part of the serious mythology of the film and the imagery that if you can get to the top of the steps in life, that's you know, yeah, you overcome all your obstacles.
Surprisingly, most of the original Rocky was filmed in Los Angeles. They only spent about 5 days here in Philly with an almost invisible film crew. For Rocky V, 150 people invaded this city for 2 months. During the first week of Rocky I, there were a lot of members of the crew that actually believed that Sylvester Stallone was just another beat-up club fighter. And now Sylvester Stallone is Sylvester Stallone. Rocky I cost about $1 million to make. Rocky V cost considerably more than that. To show you how these Rocky films are actually made, we followed the production of Rocky V from day one.
You call yourself a fighter?
Go for it.
Another Rocky.
What?
Yo.
Here we go. Roll it, please.
Rocky, coming back to Philly.
I'd rather be in a wild.
We're rolling.
To me, this is where it all began.
Action!
Why are you wearing those clothes?
Trying to get back my original audience.
Stallone? He's a brilliant performer.
Got a great sense of humor.
He's a very creative, brilliant, sensitive guy.
He's got that.
Okay. He writes the choreography of it all.
Nobody liked him in a long time. Philosopher, metaphysician, rhymer, brawler. And he's a good man.
We don't need anybody. Fire the rest of the cast. I'm playing all the parts.
He hasn't changed as much as people might think.
Sylvester?
He's always been weird and crazy.
Da-da-da. Da-da-da.
Now the glory.
Because of the continuous violent blows to the head, the effects are irreversible.
The crowds.
My husband is retired. He has nothing more to prove.
And the money are gone.
You lost millions.
Look, I still got my place in the old neighborhood.
If Big Bird ever came down this street, they'd pluck him real fast.
Philadelphia has changed drastically. And so had the character. And so have I. So the city was a perfect landscape for this kind of film.
It made me feel proud that, he would come back to the Italian market, down to his roots here, and it was just a great day.
We have our own Italian stallion over here, the elderly version of it.
And it was perfect. We didn't have to touch a thing, because this actually conveyed the way Rocky was feeling about himself, so it was great.
There's a much greater emphasis on character in this picture.
You see yourself doing right, and you do right.
People say to me, what are you doing in Rocky? You died in Rocky, didn't you? Flashback.
You see yourself doing right, and you do right.
I missed the character Mickey desperately. You know, he was the wisdom, he was the insight, and as it turns out, he's the anchor in this movie.
It's going to be like an angel on your shoulder. And if you ever get hurt and feel that you're going down, this here angel is going to whisper in your ear. He's going to say, Mickey loves you. Okay?
Okay. Thanks, Mickey. I love you too.
Me too.
That's great.
That's right.
That's great.
All right.
I won't let you down.
You're going to do that.
I've always had a penchant for boxing. Say your name is Sylvester. You better learn all about humor and how to dodge punches right from the start, okay?
The first time I met him, he faked a handshake and hit me right in the gut. And it almost killed me, but I didn't go down because I wanted the part, right?
There's a game played all the time called Five to the Head. And that was the first one who could land five slaps to the other person's head was the winner. So you developed a little bit of a style, so it wasn't like bang, 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 bang. And I guess I just slowly crossed the line and made that a career, you know what I mean?
I do. Ah!
If you fight Rocky, you're automatically a bad guy.
He's an up-and-coming heavyweight. He's 20 years old and never acted before, and has got a baby face and is not the typical-looking villain by any means.
Rocco.
Yeah?
You remember Tommy Gunn?
Oh, yeah. Hey, let's see what you got there, kid.
You know, when I was like 11, 12 years old, I remember sitting at home in Jay, Oklahoma. I was in the Sylvester Stallone fan club.
Enough. What's the matter with you?
Rocco. What?
He thinks of opportunity.
Then he comes across a young Rocky. So he thinks.
You do have a good shot to the body, I gotta admit.
He's given up his family. He's foregone his son. He's forsaken his wife, his friends, everything. He's put his entire life into this young man.
The Museum Stairs in Philadelphia are the second biggest tourist attraction in Philadelphia after the Liberty Bell.
Let me beat it.
My calves really ain't this big, you know.
You know when I realized the steps had a lot of significance with this incredible turmoil over the statue?
The Rocky saga continues. This time it's the statue. Should it remain at the Art Museum or be moved to the Spectrum?
Oh my God, it's a statue. Give it a break. What's the big deal? They actually took it up for referendum. The mayor got into it. Senators got into it. City council protested. And then they made it like Sylvester Stallone hires a lawyer to defend it. No. I wanted to take it home and put it on the hood of my car. I'm real happy. Jeez. You know, take my statue and go home. Thank you. You know.
Coming up, more action.
Action.
And excitement.
Rocky!
On the set of Rocky V with Sylvester Stallone.
I'll tell you, I've never, never seen a response like this. They can sense something.
My favorite Rocky scene would probably be the ice skating scene where he's with Adrian and she can't skate very well and he is using his shoes to try to keep up with her.
Woo! You know how I got started fighting? Huh?
No.
Am I talking too loud?
3 minutes!
My father, he's my old man. He was never too smart. He says to me, you weren't born much of a brain, you know, so you better start using your body, right? So I've become a fighter.
Huh. And that's pretty funny and moving.
One of the scenes, though, that I remember and that so many people have talked about is the scene with Sly and I on the beach. You know, the running and the racing and the embracing. I mean, time after time, men, women, children mention that scene.
Through the years, there's been so much said about the connection, the love affair between this city and Rocky. Is it really true? Well, to get the official answer, we've invited the mayor of Philadelphia, Mayor Wilson Good. Mr. Mayor?
Welcome to Philadelphia.
Thank
glad to have you here.
It's a pleasure to be here. Well, tell us, Mr. Mayor, is this love affair, is it really true?
There's no question it's true. There's a real love affair between this city and Rocky. We see him on the screen overcoming all odds, defeating opponents, struggling, winning, and in a sense, it represents the struggle of the underdog. Victory over defeat. And Rocky is, in fact, Philadelphia.
And we all love that.
Of course we do.
Now, Mr. Mayor, the real question. Did you get into the picture?
I did not.
No, neither did I. But I understand that they were very, very selective.
Well, only about 10,000 Philadelphians got in.
I guess we didn't make the cut.
Onslaught of the fans is really like something out of the Day of the Locusts.
It's every Italian's dream to meet Sylvester Stallone. Are you kidding?
His celebrity is almost bizarre.
I'm in Nirvana. I got engaged 42 times today. This is a hell of a night.
I'm only here because of the Rocky character. It's a double-edged sword for me. In one way, it's very, very flattering. In another way, it's extremely restricting. You know, especially when you go into a French restaurant and go, yo, you got any mayonnaise? You know, it doesn't work.
The audience is amazing that they can sense something. One of the great highs was the original time Rocky came out and the audience cheered. I'd say this one matched that.
Tommy came along and he just seemed to have the right essence. And he's a real fighter.
I remember the very day that I went to see Rocky One, made me want to hit people to the body a lot.
I went back, I needed some footage for this film, from the first one. It's gone. It's gone. Oh, it was like losing a piece of my body. They burn it. All the outtakes, all the footage. I said, this movie won the Oscar. How can you burn the footage? You probably have every shot I ever did in Rhinestone, but you burn the footage in Rocky? Is there no justice?
What Foley does is he signs away Rocky's money.
Yes, I've got Mr. Young right here. Mr. Young will be about five more minutes, sir, and then we'll be ready for you on the picture. Okay, sir? Thank you very much, Mr. Young. You know,
it's like being part of the family.
If you come right up here, he goes, can I drag him right here?
Can I join the human race?
Come on. He loves me. After 15 years, he finally loves me. Mr. Young, the director changed his mind, and he does need you in the picture now. When you get through here, guys, go right ahead. No problem.
Sequels are wonderful to do.
Take a look at these prices.
You thought I was in this for the money, Tommy?
Rocky didn't, he never fought for the money. He never fought for the glory. He fought because he was a fighter. This fella fights for money.
There's your boat, Rocky.
What boat?
The one that's sinking.
And he eventually turns on Rocky.
Challenge that man to fight man to man.
Now you accept the challenge or you yellow.
You tell me you're a piece of garbage, you know that?
No!
Now you knocked him down. Why don't you try knocking me down now?
Only gun, only fight in the ring.
My ring's outside.
And when Rocky's on the street, he's a much better street fighter than he ever was in the ring. So this is where the fun begins.
Here we go. Throw it, please.
Come and get it.
It's extremely physical and basic. It's going to be very fulfilling and certainly a worthy segment to be the last chapter, because it is the end of Rocky.
Nice doing business with you.
All those beatings you took in the ring, I took them with you. I know how you feel. I know when somebody like Tommy comes along, you feel alive. But he's not you. He doesn't have your heart.
It's like saying goodbye to your best friend ever. You know, it's like a deathbed scene. You know, you hold his hand and he expires in your arms, and that's kind of like what it was.
Rocky, you're losing your family.
I'm sorry. You know, it was always you and me. It was always you and me.
Coming up next, a once-in-a-lifetime meeting between Sylvester Stallone and Rocky Balboa. After 14 years, they had a lot to talk about.
I say, why don't I take after him? Why don't I start making these pictures? So I really enjoy taking after my dad and painting these pictures.
As a matter of fact, I just started painting yesterday, and he shows some promise, actually. I mean, the side of the house looks beautiful, so he's moving up. Tomorrow, we're going to move right to the garage.
Are you going to miss Rocky when you finally put the last
one? Oh, yeah.
Are you kidding? Absolutely.
Of course. I mean, I wouldn't be here without it, but then again, it's about time that we go our separate ways. It's been 15 years, and I never could believe that the series would go on as long as it has. And now the Cinderella story has come to fruition. It's gone the full circle.
Hey!
You know, when I first came here, I was told that people come to the art museum every day to run up those stairs emulating Rocky. Well, believe it or not, it does happen. For whatever reason, Rocky has touched the hearts of millions around the world. He appealed to anyone who had hoped, as he had, that there might be more to them than the world perceived. That there is a chance that they too could be champions and heroes on their own terms. I've had the pleasure of working with Sylvester Stallone a couple of times, and I consider him a friend. And to tell you the truth, he is a lot like the character of Rocky. He's gentle. He's romantic.
I want to kiss you. You don't want to kiss me back if you don't want. I don't want to kiss you.
He's always in control.
Go on and get him! Get him, get him, get him! Come on, what's the matter with you? Get him!
Well, it's time for me to say goodnight. But we end the show with that special meeting we've been telling you about. Sly and Rocky, face to face. The meeting took place at Sylvester's private art gallery in California. And now that Rocky V is complete, Sly has a new love.
Yes, there is life after Rocky. As a matter of fact, I've been doing a great deal of painting. This is a little something I worked up called Superman in the City. You may not recognize it, you may never recognize it, but I do have something you will recognize.
No, Sly! I just come to California for a vacation, so I just drop in, you know. Hey, I look, this painting, I like this painting. I look at all these colors. I mean, I look like an Indian or something, don't I?
Yeah, I remember when I won this belt here, you know, but now I've been eating all this ravioli from Adrian. I better get back to the gym.
I can't believe this. What are you doing here?
Well, you know, I figured after 14 years we should meet, and I just wanted to meet you, and I didn't have a lot to do in Philly, so here I am.
You know, this is incredible. You know, I have so much I want to say to you. After all, you did give me everything.
Yo, you gave me some stuff, too, like black eyes, bruises, Asian.
I was just kidding about the black eyes, you know.
You got a sense of humor. I like that. But I don't know about this wardrobe. And to tell you the truth, Rocky, I did think you were taller. No offense, but I'll be right back. You know, he seems like a pretty nice guy and dresses real sharp. But, you know, I can't believe I'm meeting Sylvester Stallone. Hey, yo, Rambo!
You rang?
Hey, here. I want you to have this.
We won this Academy Award in 1976 for Best Picture.
I guess we did a pretty good job, huh? Anyway, because of you and Rocky here, that's me and the rest of the Balboas, we got a pretty good life, and I just want to say, for a movie star, you're a pretty good writer, you know.
Hey, thanks. Thank you very much, but there's something I gotta know.
If we had to do it all over again, is there anything you'd change?
Yeah, are you kidding? I would never drink them raw eggs again. Hey, why'd you make me drink those things with the yolk and everything? Boy, I drunk some bad things in my life. But hey, Sly, why didn't you, like, become a fighter?
Huh? Oh. I got married, didn't I?
Hey, Sly, listen. Why don't you come over to my place and have some dinner with us? You know, Adrian is dying to meet you, and she makes some mean spaghetti, you know?
Hey, I'd love to.
Hey, yo, maybe not after you eat, you won't. Hey, listen, I want to thank you a lot for inventing me, you know. I appreciate it.
Hey, don't mention it. And listen, I'd like you to do me one favor. If you would, let's go to Philadelphia and race up the steps. I'd like to see who's the better man. Meet you in Philly?
You got it. You believe he's like these Hollywood types, you know, racing me up. They got this superiority complexion thing. Hey, Four Eyes, if I couldn't beat you up the steps, I'd do quit, you know. And I thought you were taller, too.
Not bad. Yo, Adrian, I did it!